Tonight, the Mana Cave takes part in some multiplayer magic with Conspiracy 2, Take the Crown. There can be only one king, and Travis, Steve, and Ed are going to battle it out to see which of them are worthy of the throne. Welcome to the Mana Cave.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Mana Cave. My name is Ed.
I'm Travis.
I'm Steve.
And today we are doing a Conspiracy 2 multiplayer three-way game. We did the draft. We did an actual draft, even though it was only with three players.
It's still a draft. I drafted.
Yeah.
I haven't drafted in a long time. I enjoyed it.
We were originally hoping to record the draft, but...
I felt drafty.
The logistics.
Logistically, it would be a mess. And we tried. We tried thinking of things. And
next time, maybe we'll be able to do a bit more testing beforehand and get one out there. But for now, at least you get to see the game. So this either will be the first, possibly the second game. We're going to do this as our initial game, see how it goes. And if this game blows, then we will do a second one.
How would it be the second game, though? How would this be the second game?
I could build a time machine and then learn how to play guitar. And
we're going to get her done.
Yes.
We're just going to let her rip. Let her rip.
Put him on the spot.
Yeah. We're going
to
love
it. Well, when you love talk nonsense, it's pretty easy to put on the spot. So, yes, this will definitely not be the second game. This will be either the first game or
nothing.
Or you won't see this. And that may be best, considering how I'm going on. So, we haven't rolled to see who goes first.
Yeah. We can do two dice.
We'll do two dice. Yeah.
Yeah, I need mine over here because mine is the book.
Nine. Ten.
Well, I don't like how that goes.
So Steve goes first.
I like how this is going.
Oh, we also haven't determined our opening hands yet.
But we get
so this
three
is,
mulligans too. This could take forever.
This is something that we do usually off camera.
Six, seven. And goes quickly.
Yeah, that's going to be a mulligan.
Free mulligan.
Yeah. Multiplayers get free mulligans, which is kind of a nice thing. So
it wasn't a bad hand. Just it wasn't what I was looking for. I wanted some lower costed cards. They were nice cards.
Yeah, I just wanted a land. So I find that's usually helpful in an opening hand.
Yeah.
Those who watch my Magic Online videos realize that sometimes I don't mulligan when I should.
Are you mulliganing too? Or you're.
I'm gonna regret this.
We're not forcing you to mulligan. It's not like the cool kids are mulliganing, so you have to mulligan.
But the cool kids are. I'm moving an eyelash before you have like a heart attack.
I can't stand as
much. There's probably a mustache.
Another small one here. Do you want me to cut, or do you want Steve to cut you?
Cut myself like Marilyn Manson. Or Iggy Pop.
Really? You know?
Yeah. Aww. When I play poker, I always called Manson the deck when I would cut myself. One. Two,
oh, we're definitely not doing this
right. It's not.
What?
It's not nothing. It's...
We're making masochistic jokes, or?
Oh, this is hilarious. Remember when you tell yourself you shouldn't let that first deck go, the first hand go? Nah, I'm sticking with this one.
You know, I think I'm going to stick with this one as well, too. It's not the best opening hand, but it has some land, which is important.
Yep.
So
I'm going to play a card I want to play, so... I'm sticking with it.
I'm going to horribly regret this.
Maybe. Did you mulligan?
He did. We all did. It's free.
Oh, did you sleeve your conspiracy card?
What a pimp, right?
Ooh, look at that.
Kiss. This will have to work.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I'm just going to move this over here.
I didn't let anybody cut my deck. I'm sorry.
That's okay. We trust you.
Okay.
Not really. So I have two hidden agendas, whatever conspiracies. Yep. You do too. So these are all basically hidden agendas, ones that'll get flipped up later. Okay. Because we're all still new to the rule set. We played previous conspiracy, but
you can keep it
in the sleeve.
Sorry, I want to hide my shame.
That sounded really weird the way I said it. I don't know
Come
why
on,
I made it weird.
Baby, you can keep it in the sleeve. There you go.
Okay, so Steve starts, yes.
Steve starts, yeah.
And because it's multiplayer, he gets to draw first. He gets to draw. Right? Yeah, it's multiplayer rules. Multiplayer rules. So even the person starting gets to draw a card.
Everybody drawing cards.
I love when Steve does the no-look draw. He looks at the camera and he just...
He's not pinched his nipple when he does it yet. I've now given him an idea, so who knows. Nordic land play?
Playing land, I'm tapping it. Immediately, I'm tapping.
This does not bode well.
No, this is fun. I know the card you're playing too.
Doomed Traveler.
So you love that card.
You were the one playing white. Yeah. As you draft, obviously you notice when someone else is taking
your cards. Yeah, see, here's the thing. I knew Steve was playing white because I got to use a card twice, allowed me to look at what he was drafting. So I sort of got clued into that fact. But that card, I think you liked that card in the previous conspiracy, because that's from the previous conspiracy set as well.
He's great. Included, right? This poor guy, this poor doomed traveler, dies and he still works for me. he's there, he's hanging out, and I'm passing the turn.
Passing turn to me, okay.
Poor schmuck.
I'm going to play an island, and I don't have a turn one play, so Travis, it's all yours.
I'm going to draw. Not the greatest, but I'm going to play a forest, tap that forest to play Burgeoning. Whenever an opponent plays a land, ooh, I may put a land card from my hand onto the battlefield.
Nice. Oh, nice card. Nice rare.
That one, I think.
Well, he wasn't your red and green.
No, but I was like, that's a money card, isn't it?
See, I've forgotten they draft entirely. At this point, these guys are like commenting about stuff that happened like last year.
We had the price list. Like,
I passed the turn.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
That's a show and tell, really?
Yeah. No, I thought that was a money card, wasn't it?
Yeah, Burgeoning. No, I think Burgeoning is. I don't know how much it's worth. I know it's not one of the cheapest cards.
Yeah, so. Let me trade in for more goblins. All I care about.
That's right, because that's your main thing. Is like you trade in for like an entire deck sometimes.
Because it gives you more value on the trade.
Yeah, and especially if you're not going to use it, right? So, I've sadly got that collector mentality, and I can't let certain cards go a lot of the time, and it's really really annoying. One day, I just want to take a bunch of the cards that I have that are of value and just sell them all.
And go to Vegas.
Go to Vegas. Or buy something for my wife. Love you.
In Las Vegas.
Wait, your wife watches this stuff?
No.
Because my wife doesn't.
But apparently some of her family does. So my family now. We're all family now, so.
Never call them her family.
I'm going to play a land so you can do your thingy.
I did my thingy. Did I do it right? I think I did it right.
And I'm going to attack you because I don't like what you did.
Ooh, yeah. Made a target.
I dropped 19. Yeah, made a target.
Made yourself a target.
Oh, I'm...
Sorry. There you go. Your spin counter, yeah. There you go.
Okay.
First blood.
First blood. First blood. Pass attorney.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to play Swamp. I'm going to tap two and bring out Merfolk Looter.
Oh.
It's a 1/1 Merfolk Rogue. I can tap it to draw a card, then discard a card. All I'm doing, so I'm going to pass the turn to you. Oh, but you know what? We're playing casual rule set.
I also don't have land.
Oh, okay. Well,
easy. Okay, I untap, draw, play land, and I think I've pretty much gotten the only value we're going to have Burgeoning anytime soon.
I also wanted to be sort of festive, and we're playing Magic. I bought a Hobgoblin Ale.
You got to put that close to your face.
Oh, that's right too. I keep forgetting we're tiny little boxes now. So.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tap all three to bring out.
I should hold it up like this.
Leibold's operative, drafted her face up to get an extra card, and right now she's at 3/2.
3/2,
but more than you won ones.
This is true.
And I pass a turn because she does not have haste. She does not have haste.
Before you pass the turn to me.
What? You're not going to evolve no wilds. I mean, raise no alarms.
Raise the alarm.
He's raising
the
alarm. Boom! In-step shenanigans.
In-step shenanigans.
Gotta love him. Gotta love him.
So you were the one that stole the raise the alarm from me.
And I don't have tokens.
Oh, I do. I do, but I'm hoping to need them.
They're soldiers.
Thank
tokens,
you, thank
right?
you so much. Yes, it's perfect.
Do you have
it's got my back over here.
Gender with them or something?
Okay.
Okay. So now it's your turn.
Now it's my turn.
Untap.
Doomed Traveler. I'm already trying to think two moves ahead here.
Trying to think streets ahead?
Instead of streets behind.
Or avenues beneath.
Play a mountain.
I made that one up. I'm creating that. I'm making that a thing.
I'm attacking Travis with everything.
Aggressive.
And I'm going to tap all three mana. Cast Trumpet Blast.
Oh my word.
Which is an instant attacking creatures get +2/+0 until the end of turn.
Oh my word.
I'm staying out of it.
Apparently. I think I have to lose a creature here. No, I'm gonna take six. Let me do my math here. I'm gonna take six then, right? No, that's nine.
Nine.
Censoring myself. Oh man. If I kill him, he gets another token anyway. If I take nine, I go down to 10 on turn three. Once again. What to do?
I'm being mean this game.
Just to be clear,
nice
just to
trumpet blast.
I'm staying out of this.
I know you're staying out of this. I am gonna take nine. Because no matter what, they'll kill off my dude.
I felt that, and I wasn't even the one being attacked.
I'm gonna take nine down to 10. I'm not sure that was the right move, but either way, I don't pass a turn to you, but it was your trumpet blast, so. That was the worst trumpet ever, by the way. Mm. Hey, when you get attacked for 10 damage on turn 3, that's what Pabst Blue Ribbon's for.
Pass the turn.
God, I'm scared now.
Wowza. That was a.
Can play Swamp.
I choose not to use my burgeoning.
I'm tapping all three. And I'm bringing out Skittering Crustacean. It is a 2/3 crab. It's got Monstrosity 4. I can pay 6 and a blue. And I can, if I do, and the creature isn't monstrous every time, put 4 +1/+1 counters on it, and it becomes monstrous. As long as Skittering Crustacean is monstrous, it has hexproof. But right now it's just a 2/3. I also just have that one little 1/1 Merfolk Looter. I'm going to pass the turn to you, Travis.
All right, then. I'm losing horribly. Untap. I draw. Double check something here. In hindsight, that's not a good card. Okay. I'm going to tap 3 to cast my Custode Peacekeeper. She's a 2/3. I drafted 5 cards before drafting her. So I can tap 1 white and tap this creature. I can tap a target creature with power less than or equal to 5, essentially.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to attack Steve for 3.
I'll take it.
Okay. I think that's somewhat out of order, but...
I'm going to stay out of this. Just... You guys obviously have some things to work out, so I'm just going to... I'll just be over here
if you need turn back to Steve. Well, I start doing some more math and problem solving. And...
I'm trying to make myself physically as small as possible. Like I'm not even here. When the smoke settles.
I'm trying to drink PBR out of a chalice.
You do. You have successfully. You have a very pimping chalice there.
Yeah.
We also have something special for if one of us becomes the monarch.
What I've been told is not original, because I think Loading Ready Run did too, but it's not like anyone wouldn't think, hey, let's get a
and to be honest, if I were to follow in anyone's footsteps, I would kind of, I don't mind following and voting in anyone's footsteps.
No. You guys rule.
They're not watching.
They're not watching. They're gonna watch.
I want the record to state that I had the crown for previous reasons.
Why did you have a crown, Travis?
See the camera roll. I can't talk about that. But hey, I'm 30 something now. I did not make a mum joke there when I could have. You could have. I could have. It's your turn, by the way. I could have been total mum joke.
I'm staying out of that too. Staying out of that too.
Staying out of mums. You staying out of his mum?
It's not my.
Oh,
not
wow.
My. You know what? I'm good. Then your turn. What?
Oh, wow. Okay, on your end step?
Yes.
I'm tapping more folk looter.
Okay.
I'm going to draw a card. And I guess I'm going to discard Entourage of Trest. It is one of the cards that could have made us the monarch. But sadly, I don't have green, so it's not going to be useful for me.
Tri-coloring it over here.
Whew, I hate playing three colors in draft. Hate it.
You must have loved drafting cons then. Those three, they were uncommon, weren't they? Uncommon three mana temples and such.
Well, that set made it easy. Mm-hmm. That set was like, but most sets, it's unless you have really good mana fixing, and sadly, I don't have anything on the board right now for that. I played an island.
I choose not to use my burgeoning. It seems so cool at the time.
I'm going to tap three and cast Divination to draw two cards at sorcery speed.
Terrible card.
Really? I think it's good right now.
I guess in draft limited, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's
cool. Okay, so now I am going to pass the turn to Travis.
Okay, I'm going to untap. I'm going to draw. And I played planes. I can stack them. I'm going to attack Peacekeeper Joe over here.
What? I'm staying out of this, Travis. I know, and
I've had enough PBR to be crazy. Just get crazy with it. So it was a 2-3 and a 3-2.
A 2-3 and a 3-2.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. 3-2, 2-3.
Oh. Balls.
Indeed.
I would be looking at taking five, right?
Just five.
Okay, I'm going to put the Skittering Crustacean in front of your operative.
Okay. I'm going to
play a trick.
Play a trick. It's not much of a trick. One green and one of any color to cast Strength in Numbers. Until the end of the turn, target creature gains plus X, where X is the number of attacking creatures, so there are two attacking creatures. The Leovold's operative becomes a 5/4 with trample.
It's got trample. It gets trample as well too.
Against trample.
Well, so suck.
So 2, 3, 5, 4.
So I'm taking four.
That goes on the stack though. Do you have a magical one black counter target spell?
Don't tempt me. I have no graveyard. No. So I'm taking four. My crustacean goes to the graveyard, and I'm down to 16.
I did damage to somebody, but you're not the monarch, so it doesn't mean nothing. Deep breath in, and then I'm going to tap two to bring out a bronze sable. It's useful. It has its place in the world.
I believe it's pronounced Sabal.
Nope, it's sable. And I pass the turn to you. Sabal indeed. As Steve would say, giddy up. I have a lot of
Steve good... Steve is famous for saying giddy up.
Well, there's one other person who's pretty famous for saying giddy up.
Kramer?
Yeah.
Really?
We won't talk about him, though, because, you know, the racism. Was that a Kramer thing?
No.
No, because we don't talk about him. Don't mention the Kramer.
I played a mountain.
I choose not to use my virtue. You're getting so traded in, you... What was the other one from Conspiracy 1 where it's, you can play more than one land this turn? Respite? It wasn't Respite. It
was... Exploration.
Exploration.
Yeah.
Another popular card, apparently.
Oh, yeah, it's very useful. Like, a lot of the cards that are, like, not standard, modern staples, or even legacy staples, because there are a lot of legacy legacy cards that come from Conspiracy that you can't use in any other.
Because that card wouldn't do so good even in Commander, because...
Which card?
Scout the Borders. No.
Exploration.
Exploration. Because it'd be great if you had your opening hand, because whenever anyone else played one, you could... Mm-hmm. But for that to work, you have to have it, one copy of it in your opening hand, and like three land or something.
Four land. But I think it's like anything else in Conspiracy. If you plan your deck around that particular card, it could be useful late in game. Like you get a lot of land draw. Sorry, Steve.
No problem. Are
you blasting a trumpet again?
I'm tapping two mountains to cast Goblin Thunder. A Goblin Tunneler.
Not Goblin Thunder?
No. You can tap this dude. He's a 1/1 Goblin Rogue. To give a target creature with power 2 or less the power not to be blocked this turn.
Huh. He's a goblin.
Can I do that while he's summoning sickness?
Nope.
I didn't think so.
Nope. Unless he has haste. Does he have haste?
He does not have haste.
No. The new sir. And I'm not saying that to be mean.
Come on, pretty mean.
I'm staying out of this.
All right, I'll pass it to you.
Okay. Upon your end step, I'm going to tap my Merfolk Looter. I'm going to draw a card. And I will discard a freaking swamp. And now I'm going
to
tap.
It's nice to have land to just spare like that.
Yeah, I wish one of those lands was a forest. Apparently, no.
No, that's why you don't play more than two colors.
Yes, exactly.
Here's Travis's draft advice. This is only like the second or possibly third time I've ever drafted in my life. So there's
am I taking up too much room draft here?
Advice. No. I mean, we can shell. It's going to be like it's a bit of a logistical nightmare to shoot a multicolored or multicolored multiplayer game. Right. So we are going to do our best to make
it. Nope. Upstairs. Go.
He's talking to his wife.
Talking to my dog when there's five tripods set up. So. Yeah,
because he can be a bit of a bull in the china shop. So, I'm going to pass the turn to you, Travis.
I'm not at all surprised. All right. I'm going to untap some stuff. I'm going to draw a great card. I am happy I drew that card. Okay, I've untapped. Draw. I'm going to do one of my hidden agendas. Boop, boop, boop.
He couldn't even wait. He couldn't wait.
He's getting really excited.
I lose. Summer's Bond, double agenda. Whenever you cast a creature spell with one of the chosen names, you may search library for a creature card with the other chosen name. Reveal it and put it in your hand, then shuffle your library.
Okay. So what are the chosen names?
Wings of the Guardian and Recruiter of the Guard. So I'm going to cast tap a 1 and a white. That's still... Yes. Okay. I'm doing this at a turn here, but whatever. I cast my Wing of the Guard.
Okay.
So he's a 1/1 flyer with melee.
Okay.
Now I get a search for a Recruit of the Guard. Recruiter of the Guard, which is a rare. Didn't say you couldn't choose a rare.
The melee is what?
Explain it while I look for my card.
Melee. Is whenever this creature attacks, it gets +1/+1 at the end of turn for each opponent you attacked with a creature this combat. And then I burp, sorry.
So Recruit of the Guard, it's a creature card, it's 1/1 for 3 mana. Go into my hand. I gotta shuffle my library.
Wait, you got Recruiter of the Guard?
Yep.
I hate you.
Why? I thought that'd be a good deal.
Is that the one that I'm thinking of? Is that the rare?
Yeah, it's a rare.
I hate you.
Because that was the first
That was literally the only card I cared to open, other than Sincere Visions. I haven't got a single copy of that card.
It was the first rare I opened, the first pack I drafted, and it made me choose white. Because I'm like, the
yeah,
first
no pack kidding.
Was, no, it's not that great a card. I don't know anything about Magic the Gathering. But I noticed that nothing else was good in that card, in that pack. So I'm like, oh, I guess I'm going white. Someone please
call. Not that good a card. You're really making it hard to stay out of this. You're really making it hard.
It's a 1/1.
If it's the one I'm thinking of, and I think it's the one I'm thinking of, it's a damn fine card.
17, 16. Oh, you guys are even close, too. If I completely myself open, I'm not facing a lot of damage, no offense, dudes. I'm not going to block with that. I'll easily block with that. I'll attack Ed for a 2/3 and a 3/2.
Okay.
Do your shenanigans.
In response, tapping 4. And I'm going to reveal both of my hidden agendas.
Oh.
Hidden agenda. Creatures you control with the chosen name have, when this creature dies, you may pay 1 black. Let me actually untap. Let me retap. If you do, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield. And then the other one is hidden agenda. When a creature you control with the chosen name deals combat damage to a player, you may pay 1 blue. If you do, draw a card. The chosen name I picked for both of these hidden agendas...
It's in your pocket. It should be on the card.
...is Cloaked Siren. And now I'm tap 4, and I'm playing Cloaked Siren. It's got flash, flying, and it's a 3/2. And I'm going to put that in front of your 2/3.
Okay.
Do you go damage phase?
We go damage phase.
Okay. So I take 3.
You take 3.
These trade. I pay 1 black. And grab a really cool looking, not at the top of my pile, zombie 2/2 token.
I didn't think they were that cool.
I think that's a very cool looking
zombie. Zombie there.
Thank you very much.
There's a throwback.
Okay, so I'm at, I took 3, so I'm at 13. For whoever's doing the scores.
13.
That's me.
Then I, actually, you know what? Then I'm just going to pass the turn. Well, I'll pass the turn to you while I read my other conspiracy.
Oh, I thought he was going to do it out loud.
No. There's no way that I got picked up by the microphone.
Oh, this is going to make me a target.
I would have thought attacking Travis for 10 would have been the target, but apparently not, because he only seems to want to pick on me.
I'm going to tell him. I'm evening everything out. That's all I'm doing.
Evening? Evening?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm trying to stay out of this. Thank you very much.
That's what got me more than anything else. Because I know where that strategy gets you, multiplayer. It wins.
Tap 3 mana to cast Gutter Snipe. Whenever I cast an instant or sorcery spell, Gutter Snipe deals 2 damage to each opponent.
Gutter Snipe!
Wow.
That's a nice snipe.
When it does damage? What is it?
What's whenever he casts instant or sorcery.
Oh, instant or sorcery.
Can this have any trample people up?
Up? No.
No.
Alright, I will... You know what? Out of tech.
Your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man?
I'll attack, Ed.
With the Doom Traveler?
With the Doom Traveler.
Oh, this is the squeaky chair. I forgot. I gotta be careful of it.
Yeah, stop squeaking. The folks at home.
Okay, well, I'm gonna let it through.
Okay.
Damage?
That's it.
I'm at 12.
Yeah. As far as I know, they didn't reprint Titan Strength in this. Just FYI.
No.
You got a 2/2 zombie. He had a 1/1.
I know, but it then turns into a 1 flyer, and I had no way to block a flyer.
Fair enough.
You do.
I am.
So it's interesting that you want me to create this 1/1 flyer because you know he's not going to swing on you with it. I can see what you're doing.
I'm not conspiring to anything. Just because we're both wearing Blizzard video game t-shirts, I mean we're conspiring to anything.
On your end step, tapping the looter.
Did I buy that shirt, by the way?
Dry the...
It's possible.
Conspiracy?
I think so, actually. I don't know why I threw that out there.
guess what's up the sleeves?
I found you two big sexy guns.
I'm going to discard a Beast Within because I'm apparently not getting any force anytime soon. So
when you have a moment, I want to ask you about that card.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to play Swamp. And I've got options here. Oh, I've got options.
If he passes the turn to me, he has no options.
I'm going to tap a blue and a white. Which is amazing, because I tapped a swamp, so how I got white mana out of it, I don't know. I'm going to tap a blue and a black.
That's impressive.
And I'm casting Jeering Homunculus, which has got some of the best damn art this entire set. when Jeering Homunculus enters the battlefield, you may goad target creature. Until next turn, the creature attacks each combat if able and attacks a player other than you if able. So I'm going to goad that guy. So that is going to have to attack Steve next turn.
What is a homunculus? Was that a thing before Magic the Gathering?
Well, I think the
curious homunculus,
according to Big Bang Theory, this is the only time I heard it used before that, was it's a perfectly formed miniature human being. However, this is not perfectly formed because they have one eye, so obviously it's a little bit different.
Also, his head is as big as his leg.
I'm sorry, I'm touching your token. This is moving back there just a little bit.
So yep, far by perfectly. Means,
yeah.
I'm now going to tap two blue and two black. Sorry, excuse the mess, guys. Excuse the mess. And I'm bringing out the Merfolk Sky Scout. Whenever Merfolk Sky Scout attacks or blocks, untap target permanent. It's a 2/3 flyer. And now, Travis, it's your turn. We've got a very full board here.
Populated. Populated board.
For those of you who are wondering if you happen to be looking at me on camera at any point and I do this, it's because I'm checking out the time on the overhead cam.
Fair enough. Now,
I've looked up too. I've been noted.
Oh, have you? Okay. We're keeping an eye on it.
For sure. We're not rolling our eyes or anything.
I've been goaded. I have to attack.
You have to.
With that one, yeah.
Yeah. No. Okay, well, so let's just get this all in order.
Yeah.
Sure.
Step one, I have priority. I'm flipping over another. This one is Natural Unity. Creatures you control with the chosen name, Wings of the Guard, have at the beginning of combat on your turn, you may pay green. If you do, put a +1 counter on this creature.
Okay.
So it's the beginning of combat. I'm going to pay green to put a +1 counter on him, and then pay green. Doesn't say when this creature attacks. It says at the beginning of combat, you may pay green.
Can I just see the card for that?
Please do, because I want to make sure I get this right.
Okay, no, because it's a triggered ability. So basically that trigger goes in the stack, which means you have one use of the trigger. However, okay, you get to use this every single combat phase.
I know.
So next combat phase, you'll be able to pay another green.
Okay.
And if I'm wrong,
fair enough.
Comment section below,
let us know. That's why I wanted to make sure. So I paid one green, one forest, one green, to put a +1/+1 counter on him. So I'm attacking Ed with him and Steve with him. So his melee kicks in. So now he's a 3/3 flyer.
Okay.
And you only have one creature with flying, correct?
Yes, I only have one creature with flying.
He's a 2/3.
She. I believe. Let me just check. No, I believe it's a man.
Whatever.
A merman.
I'm more concerned about his power toughness than the gender of the person on the
giant will.
Man. Okay.
I will take the damage.
You will take the... Wait, what?
I'll take the damage.
All right.
So I'm taking 3.
So am I.
You're both
taking... I'm down to 9.
Down to 14.
Okay. Dang.
Were you hoping for complicated shenanigans?
No. Give me a second to think this over.
Think away.
I'm going to tap 3 to bring out Recruit of the Guard. Recruit of the Guard is a 1/1. When it enters the battlefield, I may search my library for a creature card with converted mana cost 2 or less.
It's an awesome card. It is an awesome card.
I'm not saying it's terrible.
It's an awesome card.
I did not say it was terrible.
God, where's my and it's when it, whenever it comes into play, or is it whenever it attacks?
No, it's whenever it comes into the battlefield.
Okay.
So where's my Bronze Sable? I'm just kidding. I'm not picking a Bronze Sable. I'm picking a slightly better Wing of the Guard.
I thought you were going to say Bronze Sable.
So whatever. I,
and it goes into the battlefield in your hand?
No. You may search library for a creature card with toughness 2 or less. Oh, 2 of toughness? Hang on a second. I thought it was converted mana cost. Toughness 2 or less. Sorry, guys.
Should be.
You know what? Then
I've missed 2 mana drops.
Going to I've missed so many off my burgeoning.
I just want a forest. I haven't missed any mana drops, but I really want a forest.
Okay, I'm actually because it's toughness 2 or less. I'm going to reveal my. Reveal it. I'm going to reveal my Alpha Guard Hound. He's a flash 2/2, and when he enters the battlefield, target creature gets +0/+3 to the end of the turn. He's a 3 mana, in case that mattered. All right, that's my turn. Tapped out, pass back to Steve. Take it away, Steve.
Don't mind if I do.
Mouth to play takes so long.
What a board state. What a crazy board state.
Largo.
Cray cray.
Spanish people say this game takes Largo. Thank you, Dora the Explorer, for telling me what Largo means.
What does Largo mean?
Long.
It's a movie with Ben Affleck. Oh, wait.
Argo. I'll go f*** yourself. We can beep that out. With Ben Affleck, okay? It is Ben Affleck. It's directed. I'm sure he edited it. And starred in it. He's Ben Affleck it.
Fuck the boom mic.
You swore to for no reason.
Damn it, I gotta
bleep that
and oh my
oh my god
oh my word
oh like wait three. I just realized I'm not editing this one.
What?
I'm gonna have to download so many card images.
You know I don't bleep swears anyhow. Sorry, you played another goblin turn or
tunnel.
There you go, tunnel away then.
I dug it.
Okay, I'm going to tap a Merfolk Looter.
Okay.
To draw a card. I'm going to discard an island, because I don't need a lot of land. I'm going to block with my Merfolk Sky Scout.
Okay.
When it blocks or attacks, I can untap target permanent. I'm going to untap my Merfolk Looter.
Okay, do that.
I think so. Okay. Why did you tap it in the first place?
So I could draw a card. Then discard a card.
Oh. Yeah, I think damage goes through.
Damage goes through?
Yeah.
Okay, so your guy dies. And you're going to get a lovely, lovely spirit token.
I am.
Which I'm sure I have one right there.
Thank you kindly. I pass the turn to you.
Before turn ends, tap the Merfolk Looter and draw a card.
I'm looting away here.
Okay, this is going to seem strange.
I don't think so.
Because I've been hunting for it forever. I'm discarding a forest.
I'm guessing you got one in your last one, and you'll need one. So not that strange.
And now it's my turn, right? Untap everything. Sorry, I'm taking up a lot of real estate here.
It's that homunculus.
You were there.
Quickly gonna look through my.
I got the most itchiest nose in the world. Sorry.
It's so itchy.
Alrighty. I'm going to tap a white and a black.
That's a blue. That's a blue and a black.
I get to have a blue and a black. And bring out a foil. Omen Speaker. When Omen Speaker enters the battlefield, scry 2.
He's scrying.
He is.
Yeah. I put it on like that.
How was your time? I have no idea. 8 minutes, I think.
8 minutes, okay.
I require glasses, so who knows.
And Travis?
Yeah. Who's moved his stuff back so much.
The turn is yours.
Oh. Alright, I'm untapping. I'm drawn. Okay. I'm going to play a plains.
You've been looking for a land for a while now.
No, I haven't.
I thought you've been wanting, I thought you've been only on four for a long time.
I have, but okay. I haven't needed any more than four. I mean, never mind.
Is it needed more than four? Well, excuse me.
Really, excuse me. Okay. So let's begin combat on my turn.
It's the beginning of combat?
Beginning of combat.
I'm tapping four. Casting Bonds of Quicksilver. It's got Flash, Enchant Creature. Enchanted Creature doesn't untap during its controller's untap step.
Hold on a second. Okay.
I'm going to put that on your Wings of a Dove thing there, whatever it is.
Wings of an Angel.
So it's tapped.
Okay. No, it does. Enchanted Creature doesn't untap during its controller's untap step. I misread the card. I thought it tapped it, but so I would have done that at a different time.
Right.
But now he knows.
I've done that so many times.
Now he knows. Should he tap that creature?
Well, it's still the beginning of combat, so it doesn't have to attack. I can just pay one, no matter what, to put a green on, to a plus one counter.
Sure.
Okay. Okay.
Sure, fine. Yeah. Dude, yeah. Fine then. Do sure. it then. You know, fine
I,
then.
I felt that.
That might have been smart. So. So what does it say now? It doesn't untap during.
Your controllers during basically your untap step.
Okay. So when I tap him, he won't untap.
Yeah.
Okay. So then I'm going to still attack.
Okay.
I'm going to attack you.
Okay.
And I'm going to attack Steve. So he's going to become a 5 5? He's a. No, only a 4 4. Only a 4 4 because it was melee.
Okay. Response. I'm tapping Merfolk Loop. Drawing card.
Oh, I have an instant I'd like to cast.
Gonna discard a Smuggling Captain. Okay.
Oh wait, I have to sign blockers first, right?
No. You can this is all happening before signing blockers. If you want to do that.
Actually,
you can...
I'm sorry. We haven't gone to combat yet though, right?
Yeah, you've entered combat. You've tapped
it. Oh, no, we haven't gone to damage phase yet.
Not to damage phase, no.
Okay. I have a weird question. Okay. When does he stop becoming an attacking creature? After damage? Or is he an attacking creature then the turn?
After combat phase is done. After the combat phase is completely done. So after damage.
So damage happens. The second it happens, after damage, he's no longer an attacking creature. It matters.
Once the damage phase is completely done and we're outside of the combat phase, yeah.
So I can't cast something after damage has happened, but before combat is done?
I think you can, yeah.
Okay.
It's rare, but I think you can do it.
Okay.
Okay.
Can you both do something?
Yes. Well, could you please tell me more about Schmuck?
It's a 3-2 elf. Schmuck's a 3-2 elf.
3-2 elf. All right. I'm going to block, but I'm also going to tap two mana to cast Twin Bolt. Twin Bolt deals two damage divided as...
To the dude who's giving him every card you can imagine? But no, keep going ahead. I thought we had a conspiracy going here.
I'm going to finish reading this. Twin Bolt deals two damage divided as you choose among one or two target creatures and or players, right? Okay. So I only need to do one damage to him.
And block with one, yeah. If you block with one. Otherwise, you have to do two damage to him. I know, yeah. You block. Yeah.
I'm going to do the other damage to Ed over here.
Directly to me?
Yeah.
Directly to him. Okay.
Okay.
And definitely not the merfolk who's been drawing him. Okay.
This also triggers.
So we each lose
two life.
Okay.
So I'm at six now.
So we lose
the... I went down to eight, and now I'm at six.
To it. I go down to eight from ten.
What is this merfolk stuff you're trying to tell me?
The dude who keeps drawing him cards is a 1/1 creature.
Okay. And then merfolk Sky Scout goes in front of... that as a sacrificial lamb.
Okay.
And then the second it blocks, this untaps.
Okay.
So, or that's unstacked to untap that. You can do something.
No, I'm hoping I'm doing this right.
Okay.
Okay. So we're going through damage phase. They're going to trade.
Yeah.
There's no trample, but he's going to kill him. He's going to live.
Yep.
So he's still an attacking creature.
Yes.
I'm hoping this is done right. So I'm going to tap four to flash in Hallowed Spirit. Whenever Hallowed Spirit enters the battlefield, remove target attacking or blocking creature from combat. Will that work?
No, because combat is already done.
Okay.
Okay. Now this is a rule that I'm not sure of. So you know what? I will allow it.
Okay. Because I asked, but I didn't spell it out. Obviously.
Okay. So whenever it enters the battlefield, remove target attacking creature from combat. What is it?
Target attacking or blocking creature from combat.
Enters the battlefield. Remove target. Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to remove him from combat. This goes away. Your enchantment goes away.
It doesn't untap it.
No, he removes from combat.
Uh-huh.
So when he moves from combat, doesn't...
No, you're thinking exile.
I'm totally thinking exile. I'm thinking the wrong thing anyway, so it doesn't even matter. But no, I was thought that's like it was a balance thing.
No.
I don't know if it's not
exile or something like
no,
that.
No, I know it wasn't exile, but yeah. I thought when he bounced from combat.
No, that's fine though.
No, it doesn't untap it. Doesn't move from combat. Okay. Then I pass turn to Steve.
I'm in such bad shape right now.
Really? Because my one move didn't work the way I kind of wanted it to, so...
And that.
So then, wait a minute. If he's moving from combat, his two counters are still on.
Yeah, the two counters are still on it.
Okay.
Real.
I drew, right?
You drew.
I drew. Because I got this, and I'm going to play it.
Planes.
Oh, by the way, I did a quick rule check. Taking a creature out of combat does not untap it, so...
Yeah, I have to do this. Tap five mana.
Okay.
To cast Burn Away.
Ooh.
Burn Away deals 6 damage to target creature. When that creature dies this turn, exile all cards from its controller's graveyard.
Okay. Before that goes through, I tap it. I'm going to draw a card. Discard Opaline Unicorn. And then I have to what? Exile all cards from my graveyard?
Yes.
All my cards from my graveyard are now exiled. Put them over here. And this creature is dead. Once this goes to the graveyard, right? So this goes along with it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Well, that clears up my board state a little bit.
I really was worried about that massive graveyard.
I hate you both. So just keep doing what you're doing. I tried to stay out of it, but you guys made it real.
That's the worst you can do is try to stay out of it.
Guys made it real. So now it's...
So you have a flyer, right?
2/2 flyer and a 3/3 flyer.
Did you take your damage from this guy?
Yeah, I went from 10 down to 8.
I've already done it once to you.
Oh, from that last spell? Did he take his damage? I'm sorry, I did not. So I go to 6 from 8 because of your last instant or sorcery.
Oh, you suck!
Yeah,
I'm down to 4. I'm down to 4 then.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Okay. That's my turn, your girl.
I hate you both so much right now. It's like I can taste it. I can taste the bile.
He's getting venomous. He's getting venomous.
Too bad he doesn't have like every card in the world in his hand.
Island. Oh, speaking about cards in hand.
Uh-oh.
Tapping 4. Unnerve. Each opponent discards 2 cards. Each opponent discards 2 cards. So you got 1 card left in hand.
I do. I thought of Unnerve a lot when I was watching some of the pre-videos. I'm like, that's going to be evil in multiplayer.
Just evil. I'm like Pacino in The Third Godfather. I tried to get out, but they just kept pulling me back in.
No, you tried to stay.
So now I'm in it. Now I'm in it.
You pass and turn out without attacking, aren't you?
You have a 2/2 flyer. You have a 1/1.
Recruit of the Guard that you think is the best thing ever. And a 2/1 Bronze Sable.
What are you at?
I am at 6 now, thanks to Stevie McGee over there.
Oh, that's right. I got to move up freaking blockers for Steve's guys. Yes, I'm passing the turn. I was going to swing in to send a message to you, but apparently the message is I can't attack you. Which isn't really a message.
The glories of 3-player magic is just... It never ends.
Builds friendships! Build them. Build friendships. Play conspiracy. Want to kill your friends.
Sure.
In the game. Just so you know, I don't want to kill you guys anymore.
No problem. Have you met my gutter snipe?
I hate you both.
Do it.
Here's the thing.
I think I discarded the wrong card, actually.
You know what I should have done last turn? I should have just said, screw it. I should have swung it on Steve.
I'm swinging on Steve. I'm saying screw it. Alright. 2-2 with flyer. 1-1 and a 2-1. You're 14 life, man. You can pretty much just, you know. Of course, I probably should have swung it on Ed, but what am I going to do? Pick on poor Ed?
Here's the thing.
He's got the enchantment, and if I destroy the enchantment, I get a 3-3 flyer? What? Is that your only block you're making?
Yep.
Alright, so I'm going to tap 1, 2, and 3, 2 whites to cast the Afogard Hound Force Flashed cost, which is the same as regular cost. When he enters the battlefield, target creature plus 0, plus 3. So he's a 2-4. 2-4, eh? he'll survive, but no trample, so you'll still look at taking 3 damage of your 14 life that you have, you son of a life.
Sorry, how much, what's happening?
He's getting plus 0, plus 3 as he enters the battlefield. So he's flashing the creature, he's like, hey buddy, here's some armor.
Right.
You're now a 2-4. I read that joke already. Right. And he's gonna survive combat.
Right.
And yeah.
Okay.
So you take 3 damage, he dies, he lives. I'm somewhat stack these dudes so I can have a board state. I have a 2-2 blocker, a dude who's blocked, and I'm going to pass the turn back to you.
Over to me.
Over to you. Back to you. Back to you, Steve.
Oh, no. I'm back. Cause...
Right back to you, Steve.
It's 3.
Yeah, back to you, Steve, in the studio.
Flash. Gordon. Ah!
Dun, 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 dun. It just doesn't work for me.
No?
No, no, just
it works for me. It's just Creature of the Flash. I like Creature of the Flash. Hopefully you don't have like 3 instant sorceries in your hand. Boop, boop, boop. Bye-bye.
What's your life total? That thing's really hard 6. To read.
I'm sorry, 6. Do you want me to try it?
No, no, it's fine.
Do you want me to get you the one that's...
I have a purple brighter? One.
That purple one's hard to read, too.
You know what? I was making an observation. I really didn't mean for this to be a thing.
It's
become a thing.
Here, use that one. That's good. See, that one's... When you have dark on dark, it's not...
Anything you talk about, because... Yeah.
Here we go. I want that back, though.
Afterwards. Yeah, I'm sure you'll get it. Don't worry.
Shh. Hush now.
Buttercup, calm down. Oh, man, the conspiracy's abounding. Because initially it was like me and Steve versus Ed, I thought. But now it's like, I don't know. I know, if Steve has more life than you and I combined. That's pretty much all I need to say. I'm not like trying to goad anyone into doing this. No one would become the monarch.
I would love to attack, but I mean...
A 1-3, a 0-4, a 2-2.
Two is not...
I'll swing into my 0-4, send a message.
It should be whenever he attacks.
I know, right? It should.
It should be like a mythic.
He'd be extremely good if
he upshift him.
Was there, yeah.
Yeah, to mythic. Just make a play, man. I've been making plays without thinking. You know why? Just do it. Do it.
Is that camera recording? Yeah, it is.
Sure. What am I, a technician?
I pass the turn.
Oh, pass the turn.
Weak sauce, buddy.
I was going to tap my looter. But it's gone now. Okay. Well, I'm going to tap 2 black and 4 islands.
Bam.
And bring out Harvester of Souls. It's a 5/5 with death touch, and whenever another non-token creature dies, you may draw a card. So I'm just gonna put that right there beside the Omen Speaker. Mm-hmm. And Travis.
Normally I would blame you for not attacking a guy with the most life total, but you have nothing to really attack with. You know, that's one thing I'm sad didn't come back was Dethrone. It was a fun mechanic. Whenever you attack the player with the most life total. Especially early in the game, you can get like a 1/1 and can become a 2/2 very easily. Ooh, he is attacking.
I'm attacking you with my 2/2 zombie.
Respect. Me?
Yeah.
Little old me?
Little old you.
Dun dun dun. Dun dun dun. I have the Warcraft 3 loading screen theme song in my head.
Dun, oh, really? Dun, 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 dun,
dun. I'll take it.
So you take 2.
I do.
Put you down to what?
9.
Okay. It's Travis, terrible. I pass the turn to you, sir.
Whenever dude gets pretty liberal with that life total, I give him a word. Alright. Alright. I will attack Steve. Everything. Because you got so much life. I have definitely nothing to cast afterwards. That's awesome. So, 2/2, 1/1, 2/1, 2/2.
I'm going to move my guys out of the way so you guys can have fight this out.
2/2.
Fuck you, dude. 2/1, 2/1, 2/1, 2/2.
And he's got a card in his hand that he can't stop looking at.
I'm admiring the
looking
artwork.
Looking at or looking at?
I'm admiring the artwork on this island. I mean, plain white man.
That would be 7 damage. Wouldn't kill me.
Makes it sound so pathetic. It'd be 7 damage.
When you're at 9, 7 is like nothing. Ain't nothing.
I could start assigning blockers, but I'm hoping to make a power move next turn.
That's scary.
I'll take it.
Oh, why did you do that, dude? Because this is Travis using his card.
Unceremoniously drops it.
Is this like a mic drop moment? Or?
Strength of numbers, I guess. I got no choice, really, because I went all in. It was stupid of me. She went all in on you. So a target creature to the end of the turn gets plus X for X to them attacking creatures. So he gets +4/+4. So he becomes a 6/6 flying trample.
And that would be killing. That'd be killing me.
But now it has an easy 7 damage to my 6 without. No, it has an 8 damage.
This might actually.
I should have kept him back. I should have attacked you to get him back, and it doesn't matter. Does not matter.
You suck, sir.
I suck. It was a stupid call. I should have kept one guy back, but I think I needed that.
I'm staying out of it. That's all I'm saying. Apparently. So it's my turn now.
Your turn.
Pass it to me. Do you have any cards in hand?
I have no cards in hand and no blockers up. That was stupid of me. I wanted to be aggressive. I thought there'd be some blocking. Maybe you'd be like, I'm not going to kill
you. What is your... Wait a second. What is your...
So I could have tried to kill somebody last
turn. Are these things going to do anything?
No.
Double agendas? No? Nothing like that?
Nothing.
I'm going to swing here at 6.
I wanted to win the game. The whole thing.
Oh, that's 8.
I'm going to swing in for actually 7. Just 7.
That's game. I got nothing. That was stupid of me.
I am the king! I have taken the crown!
You were never the monarch. Nobody was a monarch.
But when you win, you become the... When you win...
Fair enough. When you win... You put the ill-fitted crown on your head. That was stupid of me.
That's right. I've won. I've become the monarch. I'm the king.
With 4 life. Come on. Why didn't I attack you with my flyer? That still would have worked.
Yep. Oh, wow. Because
it just says attacking creature, but then I would need 1 black to block.
Well, this casual rule set, we can roll it back 2 times.
No, because it doesn't say whatever attacking that player. It says attacking creature, so I could have... And I should have kept the 1 blocker, attacked you with my flyer, and then just delayed it 1 more round, and I might have won. May have, K have, said have.
You should never have tried to take my throne. That's where it all went wrong.
Your first move was going
to be. So my first act as king will be to thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Burgeoning didn't do much.
Questions?
Oh, it's interesting.
Any questions, advice, stories on your own conspiracy drafts, please leave that in the comment section.
Absolutely.
And
play multiplayer. If you're only playing single player at a time, try multiplayer. It literally, as you've seen, changes everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all different.
It builds. If you're low on rage and you need to build some up inside you and you want to hate your friends for like only an hour or so, play multiplayer because nothing's better for it. No, it is a lot of fun.
It's fun and it changes everything. I mean, I will say that some strategy is not as relevant, but it's more fun because just who knows what's going to happen?
Who knows?
You attack, you leave yourself defenseless.
There you go. Anyways, thank you guys very much for watching and we'll see you next week.
Yes.
See you then.